Good afternoon. I am Tawatia Washdewi. I am known as Lisa Marie Ayat. I am from the Shichungo Lakota Oshpaye, the Rose Basue tribe. My mother is Roseanne Packard from St. Francis, South Dakota, where I grew up. My father is Niha Wu Grovan for Buffalo Run. He is known as Reuben Cochran. He is from the Fort Belknap Grovan tribe, the White Clay people. I am an enrolled member of the White Clay people, my father's tribe, but I grew up and live as a Shichungo Lakota. If the Tribal Law and Order Act had existed 16 years ago, my story would be very different. On May 15, 1994, I was living with my two daughters on the Rosebud Reservation. That night, I was violently beaten and raped. My little girls saw the assault and hid in the bedroom. I received medical treatment at the Indian Health Service Hospital, but no doctors talked to me about the rape. I had to wait all night for someone to collect DNA. Tribal police suspected a local man, but no federal investigators interviewed me. Federal authorities declined to get involved because the attacker had not used a weapon. A few months later, the same man assaulted another woman. It wasn't until he raped a teenage girl that he was finally arrested and convicted. He was never prosecuted for raping me. The Tribal Law and Order Act will prevent cases like mine from slipping through the cracks. There will be standardized sexual assault policies and protocols at IHS facilities. Improved evidence collection will boost conviction rates. And expanded training of tribal enforcement officers will ensure that victims of domestic violence and sexual assault will be met by authorities who understand their cases. I am now an advocate for victims of sexual and domestic violence. I know the act will help tribes keep their communities safe.
And I'll I'll be signing the Tribal Law and Order Act into law today. And in doing so, I intend to send a clear message that all of our people, whether they live in our biggest cities or our most remote reservations, have the right to feel safe in their own communities and to raise their children in peace. All of you come at this from different angles, but you're united in support of this bill because you believe, like I do, that it is unconscionable that crime rates in Indian country are more than twice the national average, and up to 20 times the national average on some reservations. And all of you believe, like I do, that when one in three Native American women will be raped in their lifetimes, that is an assault on our national conscience, it is an affront to our shared humanity, it is something that we cannot allow to continue. And that's why earlier this year, after extensive consultations with tribal leaders, Attorney General Holder announced significant reforms to increase prosecutions of crimes committed in Indian country. So we're moving forward, and we're making progress. And as we celebrate today, I'm reminded of a visit I made a couple of years ago to the Crow Nation out in Montana. While I was there, I was adopted into the nation by a wonderful couple, Hartford and Mary Black Eagle. So I'm Barack Black Eagle, that I'm proud to sign into law today. Thank you very much, everybody. God bless you. God bless the United States of America.